We're here at the Riverside Convention Center where executive chef Brad Martin is hosting a Chopped competition with the culinary CTE students of Ramona High School. The students have been broken up into four teams with one objective, to cook the best dish they can with the main protein as chicken and a secret ingredient, edamame.
Today we're at the convention center for a very unique and exceptional opportunity. The kids are getting to compete in a Chopped-like situation. So I have four teams of four students and they're all going at it with their culinary prowess and skill. So the protein that they have to work with today are whole chickens. So they are breaking down an entire chicken. They could choose to roast it whole, but I haven't seen any in there doing that. They are all breaking down their chicken to use in a variety of ways. Edamame tends to be an Asian ingredient, but is interesting to watch as teams are putting it into Italian and American and other types of culinary.
So my name's Brad Martin. I've been in this industry since I was 16 years old. To me, each day in the kitchen is a great day. I can say that I'm going to work and do something that I love to do. And I want to spread that from whoever I come across.
So we came in with the idea that we wanted to do something with like a lemon pepper chicken theme. And then once we had the edamame seeds and we saw that, we started going towards like an Asian style dish. Our sous chef brought out like different Asian style flavors. And then he showed us like some sweet, some that were spicy. And we decided to go like in the middle of the two, but more towards the sweet side. And so we kind of went sweet. And then like at the end, you felt a little bit of kick. And then we kind of like evened it out with a little bit of saltiness.
Our chef helped us out with picking out different vegetables that we should use, and we ended up deciding that we're going to do a grilled chicken with a lemon pepper.
So we really wanted to incorporate the edamame in our mashed potatoes. So what we did was, it's still going to be like a creamy mashed potatoes, but it's going to be like a different side because it's going to be the edamame in it, and it really gives it like a fresh vegetable taste that's not really something that you taste before. And then for our, we have vegetables, so we have squash, cucumbers, and carrots, and it's going to be like a string vegetable stir fry.
This is my second competition I've done for like doing culinary, and I try and just stay like positive and just be more excited than like stressed. Because in the end, it's for fun, you know?
So we're making a pasta alfredo with the soybeans with the as a puree. Right now we have it sitting in butter and water. We just add a little salt, so we're just gonna let it first soften up. We're gonna put it in a blender, and then we're gonna put it on top. Hillary's making we're making the pasta handmade. We're using the chicken breast as the main source of meat. We're making a chicken stock right now to add more flavor to the chicken after. Oh, we're all pretty good. We're all pretty confident going into this, you know, like no one's really struggling with anything.
So when we decided to do Chopped, we thought, wouldn't it be great to have RAM TV come with Ramona Culinary? Those students as well are doing an internship at Riverside Convention Center, and they are videotaping our own culinary students with the executive chef Brad Martin. Why not get some job shadowing in and cross-train everybody?
We're gonna make a grilled chicken. We mix it with a bunch of different type of seasoning to make it way more flavorful, and for a side part, we're having like a pico de gallo type of thing. Like it's gonna be sweet and spicy, so it's like a type of sweet and spicy type of deal here. We're trying to find mango, but we didn't have any, so we're putting pineapple and some other type of vegetables like bell pepper, onions, and all this other stuff. Well, first we're gonna make it into like little cubes, right? It's like, that's gonna make it super colorful. We add some lemon, it's gonna make it nice and sweet. We have to cut off the breast, debone it. Then we season it with paprika, onion powder, cilantro, lemon, and all these other type of spices. Then we grilled it in like an angle. Then we grilled the other angle to make it look like it has a diamond shape for presentation. It's like, it's hot and we have to be like really fast.
Yeah.
Like in the real world, like chefs have to move all around. But it's like, it's pretty cool. I love this experience.
So basically we got onions, put it in a pot with water, put the rest of the bones that we didn't use into the chicken, put it together, boiled it until it was done, put carrots, onions. When we take it out, we drain it and we just use the juice.
Yeah.
So it gives it a little bit of flavor to the rice we're gonna put in to mix it in. We sauteed the secret ingredient into the rice mixed with the chicken stock. So it'll be cooked and mixed in with the chicken stock and rice. I feel really good about it. It smells good. It smelled good before it was cooked, and it's gonna smell good right now.
Career technical education is hands-on experience for students. We have 38 pathways within Riverside Unified School District. Ramona High School has some specialized fields, such as RAM TV, media production, culinary, HBA program. Soon a construction program will be heading the market there at Ramona.
And then we have, this is called Honcho Citrus Chicken. We had a habanero citrus flavor to the chicken because we're in downtown Riverside and this is our community. So we wanted to make a dish that represented us and where we came from. So we gave it a little citrus taste to it. We have purple potatoes because we thought it was very exotic, different. Well, we put them in the steamer for about 10 minutes and then we took them out, put them in a mixer, mashed them up, add salt, pepper, and it tastes awesome. I mean, it's gonna love it.
We're roasting half the chicken and it's gonna have like a citrus style flavor, along with like some lime and salt and pepper, so it's gonna be more like, kind of more vibrant of a chicken. For our sides, we're gonna have organic carrots. They're like weird carrots I've never seen. They're like yellow, purple, and orange.
We're feeling good, just dragging our feet a bit because our dish was pretty fairly quick. It didn't take as long as the others. Having fun back there, just enjoying the moment of the day.
The biggest issue is that we can teach kids in the classroom what it's like to be a chef or to do videography, but for them to actually go out into the world and actually practice those skills and learn while they're doing is the most significant.
After tasting all this, all I can say is there's a clear winner. Is that this Asian chicken, grilled chicken, is the best. It's so juicy and tender. That's it.
Everybody in this building worked very hard. I mean, I think everybody's dishes were great. I think mine's, me and Zeke's, was just outstanding with our habanero citrus flavor and honey. I mean, that seasoning is the best, honestly. Try it at home, people.
Team one. It was like an island-inspired dish with the pineapple relish. He was very happy with everybody in your ideas and bringing forth the concept to the dish. Good job with the island chicken. Team two was the fettuccine chicken. Very creative. Good job in coming up with making your own pasta. Definitely good job with doing that. And you see, making pasta is really not too crazy. Team three, this was the teriyaki chicken with the mashed potatoes. The little Asian vegetable, we'll call the spaghetti veg. Very well-rounded dish, good presentation. Four, the citrus chicken and your purple mashed potatoes. Again, good flavors, good presentations. Everyone participating in on that one. Everyone did a really good job within what was handed to you, which leads us to the island chicken for first place. Never stop trying food. Even if you don't like it 3 years ago, try it again.
It was a fabulous idea. I love the young minds and spirits that can expand from a culinary perspective and to taking something like this on.
Yeah, it was honestly great, and we would like to thank the Riverside Convention Center for letting us use their facilities, and you. Thank you, Brad.
My pleasure.
All right.
I would love to see you guys come back and see it again at some time soon.
Of course. All right, thank you so much.
You got it.
Well, that's it for this year's CHOP competition. We'll see you soon.